The Albanian nation was formed by famous Albanian warrior called Skenderbeg, who lived in XV century during the time of Ottoman Empire. Skenderbeu was born in Kruha from Joan Kastriati, Lord AF Middle Albania. Yerj Kastriati attended military school in the Ottoman Empire and was named Iskander Bey, which in Turkish means Lord Alexander. They give him this name because of respect that he gained from Ottoman Turks. Skenderbeg was distinguished as one of the best officers in several Ottoman campaigns both in Asia Minor and in Europe, and the Sultan appointed him general. He even fought against Greeks, Serbs and Hungarians, but before he returned to Europe he was engaged in East Asia. But because of strong resistance that Turks have received from Albanian people in South Europe, advisor of Ottoman leader suggested to Sultan to draw Skenderbeg from Asia and send him in Albania because he is from the same people and he know their tactics and nature of fighting. Sultan Murat II gave him the title Vali, which made him the general governor of some provinces in central Albania. He was respected everywhere. In 1443, during the battle against the Hungarians of Hunyadi Niš, in present-day Serbia, he abandoned the Ottoman army and captured Kruha. Above the castle he rose the Albanian flag, a red flag with the black double-headed eagle, the present-day Albanian flag, and pronounced to Skenderbeg's countrymen the famous words, "I have not brought you liberty, I found it here, among you." Which means that he intended to bring Islamic religion, but he found out that most of Albanian people already has been converted to Islam, but the reason why they resist Ottoman Muslim was because the Ottomans in that time have changed Islamic rules of tax fees and made them too high as they supposed to be, and which poor Albanian people could not afford to pay. That's why Skenderbeg's countrymen the famous words, "I have not brought you liberty, I found it here, among you." During the next 25 years he fought, with forces rarely exceeding 20,000 against the most powerful army of that time and defeated it for 25 years. In 1466 and 1467, the conqueror of Constantinople led the Turkish army himself against Skenderbeg and failed. The Ottoman Empire attempted to conquer Kruha 24 times and failed all 24 of them. Kruha, under the direction of Skenderbeg, defeated the Turkish army led by the Sultan Mehmed etc. for a quarter of a century. As the British military strategist Wolfe has said, Skenderbeg surpassed all the captains, both ancient and modern, in his ability to lead a small defensive army. After Skenderbeg's death from natural causes in 1468 in Lezza, his soldiers resisted the Turks for the next 12 years, then 10 years under the direction of Lek Dugagin, till at the 16th of June 1478 when it fell definitively to the Sultan Mehmet. In 1480 Albania was finally conquered by Ottoman Empire. After the Ottoman took their dearly won castle of Kruha, they rebuilt the walls on the northern side, with openings for firearms, to make Kruha as impregnable against the Albanians as it had been impregnable against themselves. The Catholic history and media say that the Turkish found the grave of Skenderbeg in St. Nicholas Church of Lezza. They opened it and held his bones like talismans for luck, but for all this they have no evidence because the Islamic way of believing does not allow that Muslim can believe in anything except one God, and it is strongly forbidden in Islam to take any kind of talismans as symbol of luck or protection. Christian history try to convince Albanian people that Skenderbeg in his end converted to Christianity again. That's why they say that his bones was found in church, and for that they have no evidence, and all this they say because they want to propose to Albanian Muslims to reconvert to Christianity like their leader Skenderbeg. As I prove that Christians have no evidence is that is not a tradition in Christianity to make graves in church. Second proof is, that if Skenderbeg has been returned to Christianity, all his followers and people will return in Christianity with him because they was free from Turks and it was no reason for fear from them. How many historical say that Albanians became Muslim because of fear from Ottoman Turks? Anyway, during Skenderbeg has lead his people, they was not under Ottoman Islamic occupation, that means that they could converted to Christianity back without fear from Ottoman Muslims. But why Albanian people still remain 80% Muslims? Today among complete Albanian people Muslims population is 80%, Catholic 15% and 4% is Orthodox Christian.